we have to give that up? And also, should we stop women drinking? The teenage girls are more likely than the boys to binge drink. Now, we need the teenage girls for the next generation of wives and mothers, and we want our offspring to be healthy. So as far as I'm concerned, we should stop the women drinking. Now, that's enough. I've got stacks more for you, but I must go to the telephones because we're absolutely styled out. Ring and ring and ring and ring and ring and ring until you are blue in the pus as much as you can, but keep ringing and ringing and ringing. You know, if you don't get answered right away, please, please don't panic. Remember, this is a very, very, very big phone-in program on a very big radio station. Off I go to the telephones. I'm talking to Queenie, who's in our broth. Hello, Queenie.
Hello, Scottie. How are you doing?
How are you doing, sir?
I've never been on the phone to you before, but I was thinking that was a terrible thing about that cruelty to that guy with the cruelty channel on Facebook. And the reason why I'm phoning is, Auntie Sandra McGregor from Beale Drive in Glasgow had asked me to phone you, so she'll be listening in, Scottie.
Hello, Auntie Sandra. Dinky do. Listen, are you listening up in the broth there?
I'm actually trying to get you on the...
On the internet?
No, on the radio.
Well, if you're in a broth, it might be a wee bit shushy.
There were
96.3 96.3. So give it a try. You know, it's a fine night tonight, and you never know.
It's actually Montrose I'm in, Scottie.
Oh, you're in Montrose.
Yes.
Oh, I love Montrose.
Uh-huh.
Oh, beautiful.
I listen to your sister station a lot. I'll not mention it, though.
Yes, no. We know the one you mean. That's no problem. we'll give you a wave. we might give you... how many waves should we give you, would you say?
As many as you like.
what sort of number of waves would you like us to give you?
Oh, for God's sake. I was listening to your programme last week. I was down visiting Auntie Sandra, so...
Yes, excellent. Well, listen, you come on any time because you're very welcome.
Thank you very much.
And how's things up in their broth? Are they still doing the smokies?
They're still doing the smokies,
yes. There was a stoosh over that, wasn't
they're
there?
They're still doing the smokies, yes.
Yeah, oh, that's lovely. There was a wee stoosh about it. The Europeans were saying they would need to put in extra this, that and the next thing.
Uh-huh.
Stuff they've been doing for hundreds of years up there.
That's right.
I don't know, it's a lovely part of it.
Have you been up in Montrose?
Yes, I know broth and I know Montrose.
Yes.
You know, and the beach of Montrose is beautiful.
Right.
Oh, absolutely gorgeous. I stayed in an hotel in the main street. I won't mention any names.
No.
The main street years and years and years ago.
Yeah.
I think it was preheating days.
Right.
So it was quite. It was winter.
Uh huh.
And it was quite fresh.
Right.
And that was inside.
Oh my God. You're some man. I'm glad you listened to your programme last week. I was down in Glasgow for a week there and I was listening to your programme.
Did you like it?
Yes, I did.
Oh, that's good. Well,
I think it's brilliant, actually. Yeah.
Do you think it would go well in Montrose?
Oh, I think it would go. I think it would go in definitely with. And in Broad.
And Broad as well.
And Dundee as well.
And Dundee. It reminds me of the old joke, isn't it? Is Jeannie coming out? No, she's at her Broad.
Aye, there enough.
Oh, I'm not.
If you say it to Auntie Sandra, I'm asking for her.
I will send her love, and I'd love to your good self.
Thank you, Scotty.
And we'll maybe hear from you next time you're doing.
Thank you. Yes, certainly, Scotty.
All right, so when you get the internet in, you get on to Q96.net.
Wait a minute, can I tell you that, Scotty? Oh, you can, of course. Q96.net. 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 Q
game. I have to move on. David, and come on up.
All right, Scott, how's it going, mate?
How we doing, bud? Didn't you do?
Aye, didn't you do, pal? Andrew, why did you put your phone in, mate?
What have you done?
No, Andrew, I said, why did you put your phone in?
Oh, dear knows. Listen, if I knew that, he wouldn't have put it down. I'd have told
him. Right, so
you've
been
here
last night?
Sometimes people bottle it when they hear they get their name called and go, oh no!
Why?
You know, their bottle goes.
You've been here last night?
Oh, busy! Busy last night! I could have got on to about 3 in the morning, but still busy.
Well, Well, I'm in the
stadium, they don't step it through the hole, right? It's the same again tonight.
Oh, I know. Aye.
You know, so there you go.
What like Dumbarton? I like his accordion.
Oh, his accordion playing was magnificent.
Aye.
Yes, Willie from Dumbarton, two reels.
Aye, you get the big box from me, aye.
Aye, the big box, absolutely.
Aye.
So I might give you a tune myself if you're a good man.
Aye, I'm a good
Scotty,
please.
Okay, dinky doo to you. Dan from Paisley.
Dinky doo, Scotty.
How are you doing, Dan? How are we doing?
Oh, not too bad. I'm not too happy with you tonight.
Why, what's up?
I'm a mature student.
A mature student? Are you a lazy layabout?
Definitely not. I'm at 9 o'clock in the morning.
Do you sponge off the state?
No, I worked all my life and decided to go back to college.
Have you high in drinking drugs?
Nope.
Have you got soaring debt?
Nope.
There you go.
I'm a student who's got student loans right enough.
Right. Now, I don't think we should be lending students any money because they can't handle it. I think it's as good as kissing it ta-ta.
What, the pittance they give you?
How do you mean the pittance? A student loan, we never used to get anything. The banks wouldn't really touch us.
Yeah, bank, Scott, you got a grant for the government.
Oh, a grant? Yeah, but that hardly touch, yes.
Yeah, but
if it's
the loan is the same sort of thing, it's so supposed to replace the grant and it's a pittance.
Oh, it's not replacing the grant if you have to pay it back, is it?
Ah, you have to pay it back, exactly. Do you think it's high time we went back to the grant system?
Well, do you think that actually they should just write off the student loans?
Definitely. I mean, I've worked all my life. I'm in my 30s.
Right. Now, listen, what prompted you to go and do a course then?
A change of career.
Have you got a university degree before?
No.
Right. So what the change of career? What actually was the stim? Did you make your own decision? Do you think, I'm going to get myself a higher education?
Aye, I was sick of being dead-end jobs.
Right. So you went for it?
I went for it, and I don't regret it, but I'm worse off than I was when I was working.
You probably will be. What stage are you at?
Well, I'm going to the first year of university in September after doing a college course for a year.
Right. And what degree are you going to do?
Business law.
Lovely. I like it. Yes, I...
So, I mean, certainly you can't be calling me... You certainly can't say the students are sponges. I mean, the people that I'm in class with, there are half a dozen or so mature students that have given up jobs.
Right. And do you think you'll end up having to take another job just to fund your course?
Oh, definitely are.
Right, and but will that fit in? Are you still going to do your business law?
It'll be a struggle. I mean, I've got friends who have worked through their final year of their degree course just now. And they're up to their eyes in debt.
Right, listen to me. This is just for you, right? Never mind the rest of them, because there are a lot of layabouts in the student population. Let me give you this one, then. Here's a wee bit of advice for what it's worth, right?
Yeah.
See when you go for a job, see when you look for something to fund your course.
Uh-huh.
Aim a little bit higher than you might be tempted to, because you might think, oh, that'll do just now. That'll ease the financial burden, right?
Uh-huh.
Aim a bit higher. Go for something that requires an element of business law and say that you are doing your degree as we speak. Right? Uh-huh. So in other words, something to do with maybe the layer below company directors.
Right.
Right? And actually aim for that. Go and pitch them and do that, because a lot of people don't. They think, oh, I better know. Right? Ring these companies up because they're desperate for people working at your level.
But see, the thing is, I'm competing against 18 and 19-year-olds.
Never mind that, right? They don't matter. You're the person that matters. This is the moment, and I am the one, is what you've got to say, right? Now, but you see, you've just given me a negative there, but you see... I bet you see, doesn't it pay your bills?
No, this is true. It doesn't pay you. I mean, you're telling all students for the same brush.
Well, yes, I am indeed. You know, but I mean, I accept that you're obviously an exception. But what I'm saying to you is, when it comes to funding it, don't take a job stacking shelves or sweeping floors, right?
Like, oh, no, we've never had a work myself to that. I mean,
it's not even a question of lowering yourself. I mean, a job's a job. I've done all sorts of jobs, washing up in places and everything, right? But then all I'm saying to you is to go as high as you can, so that maybe try and find a company that might even help to fund the degree course.
That's an idea. I never thought of that one.
There you go, see?
I mean, you don't think that this student loan nonsense and this graduate endowment that you've now got to pay as well on top of your student loan is a load of nonsense?
Well, it's interesting. I mean, that's what we're going to be discussing over the course of evening, so stick with us. But let me know at some point how you get on.
I certainly will, Scotty.
And trust me, follow that one up, okay?
I will do.
And all the very best with it, Dan.
And to you.
Cheers now, bud. All the best.
All
right. Right, to the telephones, folks, as quickly as you possibly can. We're exceptionally busy. Keep the calls coming. Andrew on Animal Cruelty.
Hi, Scotty. How are you, darling?
Dinky dear.
Dinky dear. I'm not bad
for my age. Not bad for my age.
What? I see that. I see that selfie. I'm looking at his hair of a civil. Was he?
No. He was what?
He was hair of a civil.
Oh, he was awfully nice, yes.
Yeah, I got that growth on Sunday.
There's nothing wrong with a bit of civility, is there?
Yeah, I was a growth on Sunday and it was lovely.
You're not a growth man?
No, I'm
painful,
buddy.
Right, well, yeah, well, I know that, but I mean, I just wondered if you're, when I say you're in a broth, I don't mean, are you from a broth? Are you a man that likes a broth?
Yeah, I was doing Sunday for a dog show.
Right.
And it was lovely.
Did you win?
Well, I got reserved best in show.
Right, excellent. And did you have a dog with you?
Oh, of course I did. I had a wee acting pincher with me. With your cheeky old son. I went talking about animal cruelty, though.
Right, go on, sir.
I actually studied animal health and welfare at university.
Good man.
And I think people who see animals like that should be shot at dawn.
Well, yes, I mean, obviously the shooting is extreme, but I mean, you know, I think we should be looking at this. This guy could find £690, right?
Uh-huh.
And the dog is in a dreadful, the suffering must have been terrible, you know.
It was absolutely horrendous.
So, I mean, I think that we've got to look at jail sentences.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, I don't know about life in prison, but it should definitely...
Yeah, but I'll tell you, can you imagine, because even in with the old lags in the neck there, actually, they'll not take kindly to somebody who's been mistreating a dog.
That's right. I mean, it was her dog was absolutely emaciated. It was a horrendous state.
Yes. Yes. Shocking. Shocking. So that's what I think.
And also, Scott, see Daniel's just off the phone there?
Yes.
I think
it was when
she came
and
said
you
wouldn't
lower
yourself
to labour. Yes, I didn't like that. I'll be honest with you, that's why I pulled him up. I said, well, it's not a question of lowering yourself, because I mean, you and I have done all sorts of things, you know, doing the lavies and washing
and
up.
Some, and some smashing cleaners about this
took me nice. Quality stuff. I would never listen. Here, in a lot of businesses, the cleaners are more important than the board of directors.
That is very, very true.
Do you know what I mean? If the place is clean, then all the rest of it.
The hospitals, cleaners are mandatory.
Absolutely vital, and here did you see a paper in the lavies and all that sort of stuff? It's vital. Oh no, no, I rate the cleaners extremely highly.
Yeah, and I was really glad that you pulled them up about it.
I did indeed, sir. And listen, you take care of yourself.
You take care, Squatty.
All right, we'll chat later, Andrew. Thank you. Bye. Right, to the telephones, folks. We are exceptionally busy. You won't get through at the moment. As soon as there's a line free, I promise I will let you know. If you're on the line ringing, stay exactly there. Do not hang up your phone, because I'm going into the commercial break, because if you're not there, you might never get back on at all. It's only a few pennies. It's a local call, 01414290.